श्री एन के सिंह चेयरमैन द 15th फिनेंस कमीशन, श्री अमित खरे सेक्रेटरी टू गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन, डॉक्टर आर चिदम्बरम चेयरमैन ऑफ द बोर्ड आईआईटी जोधपुर, प्रोफेसर शांतनु चौधरी डायरेक्टर आईआईटी जोधपुर महाराजा जोधपुर, श्री एस आर वडेरा चेयरमैन ऑफ द फाउंडेशन डे कमिटी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड मेंबर्स ऑफ द फैकल्टी एंड स्टाफ, एस्टीम्ड एलुमनाई एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डिलाइटेड टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द फाउंडेशन डे प्रोग्राम ऑफ द इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी जोधपुर. आई थैंक प्रोफेसर शांतनु चौधरी एंड हिज टीम फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी टू द सेलिब्रेशन. I would also like to thank Sri N.K. Singh who encouraged me to be with all of you on this day, as Sri Khare also pointed out. I was not very sure whether it will be feasible to attend, but Sri Singh, who is well respected and a very distinguished civil servant of the country, and he is so persuasive, it is all very difficult to say no to him. But in any case, I am fortunate to be with all of you today. In fact, Sri Singh and I were to visit Jodhpur campus some months ago, but we could not do so because of the COVID-19 situation. At the outset, I would like to congratulate all the awardees, students, researchers, and teachers for receiving the awards today. As it has been pointed out, IIT Jodhpur completes 12 years of its existence and enters the 13th year today. For an individual, this would mark the onset of the teenage phase in life. In this phase of life, foundational changes occur, not only physical characteristics, but ideas, relationships, and core inner values developed in this stage influence one's future. This institute, with a dozen departments offering a broad spectrum of BTech, postgraduate, and PhD program options in a wide range of subjects and disciplines. And also, as the director pointed out, there are so many other multidisciplinary and varied areas of work and research. With this institute, IIT Jodhpur today embarks on its teenage journey. This would imply evolution through collaborations and friendships, and encourage critical thinking and deepening of attitude of scientific inquiry. In the post-COVID world, as technologies evolve, this will impact social, economic, and human activities in a more comprehensive manner. I congratulate all of you at the beginning of this new phase in the life of your institute, when it begins a journey that looks uncertain and challenging, and yet, if used wisely, is full of promise and opportunity. I have been asked to speak on the role of technology in shaping education, the future vistas. Coincidentally, today's program, this Foundation Day program, is organized using a technology platform without all of us traveling to Jodhpur, which would have meant more time, travel, and other aspects of logistics. So the topic for today, in my view, is in sync with the way we are interacting virtually. However, it also deprives us of face-to-face interaction, seeing for ourselves the ambience of the institute and the experience, the warmth and hospitality of all of you. In other words, had there been no COVID situation, possibly we would have been at Jodhpur in the midst of all of you. We would have had the opportunity to have face-to-face interaction, but at the same time, traveling and all that would have taken time. This brings us to the dilemmas and limitations, the relevance, use, and efficacy of technology that could pose new challenges in the coming years, particularly in the post-COVID world. In other words, technology will enable us to participate in such program with ease and less time. At the same time, we will not be having certain types of experience. So when technology is used, there will be issues of social and personal interactions. Over the past 5 years, I have had several opportunities of addressing students on the occasion of their convocations. I would often speak a few words on how technology was changing the way we live and work, and how game changer ideas such as smartphone revolution, artificial intelligence, augmented reality, robotics, blockchain technologies, and Internet of Things would usher in an era at a much faster pace than ever before. But I never expected that the situation would be transformed so dramatically, so quickly. During the last 6 months, things have changed in a way one could not imagine earlier. The role of technology has become predominant. There is no doubt that in the coming days, the pace of evolution will be much faster and the transformation will be more widespread and comprehensive. This impact will be felt much more strongly in the field of education. Technology-enabled learning can bring in not only transformational change in delivery of online education experience, but it can also enhance and supplement regular classroom-based pedagogy. It could offer more flexibility and learning support than the traditional formats. Technology offers teachers the opportunity to become more collaborative and extend learning beyond the classrooms. Educators could create learning communities comprising students, fellow educators, and experts in various disciplines around the world. This environment of enhanced collaboration offers access to instructional materials as well as resources and tools to create, manage, and assess their quality and usefulness. In recent years, use of digital technologies in higher education has received much attention across the world. In the country, in India, Government of India is encouraging several e-learning projects under the National Mission on Education through ICT initiatives, such as Swayam, Swayam Prabha, National Digital Library, E-Jantra, Virtual Lab that are helping students as well as teachers in upskilling as well as providing them quality resources. Mr. Khare, Secretary of Education, has been very proactive in ensuring that all these work much better than what used to be a year ago. In addition, these efforts are leading to creation of knowledge tools that impart not only quality education and accessibility, but also encourage creativity and innovation, particularly among young students. Most of you would be aware, as it has been mentioned earlier by other speakers, that only 4 days ago, the new National Education Policy 2020 was announced. The new education policy, replacing the earlier policy introduced 34 years ago, envisages major reforms in the education system. The emphasis is on holistic and multidisciplinary education with flexibility of subjects and provisions for multiple entry and exit. It focuses a great deal on technology use and integration. It gives a thrust to technological innovations for the purpose of improving teaching, learning, and evaluation processes, supporting teacher preparation and professional development, enhancing educational access, and streamlining educational learning, management, and administration, including processes related to admission, attendance, and assessment. If I could quote at some length, the NEP recognizes that, I quote, India is a global leader in information and communication technology and in other cutting-edge domains such as space. The Digital India campaign is helping to transform the entire nation into a digitally empowered society and knowledge economy. While education will play a critical role in this transformation, technology itself will play an important role in the improvement of educational processes and outcomes. Thus, the relationship between technology and education at all levels is bidirectional, unquote. In other words, technology will help education, learning, and its processes. At the same time, education itself can help develop newer technologies and newer applications. The NEP goes on to say, I quote, new technologies involving artificial intelligence, machine learning, blockchains, smart boards, handheld computing devices, adaptive computer testing for student development, and other forms of educational software and hardware will not just change what students learn in the classroom, but how they learn, not just what they learn, but how they learn. And thus, these areas and beyond will require extensive research, both on technological as well as educational fronts, unquote. Again, you know, what it says that technology will help education, but it also needs certain research and development and transformation of educational processes. It is proposed to set up an autonomous body, the National Educational Technology Forum, to provide a platform for free exchange of ideas and use of technology to enhance learning, assessment, planning, administration, and so on, both for school and higher education. The NETF will maintain regular inflow of authentic data from various sources, including educational technology, innovators, and practitioners. It will engage with a diverse set of researchers to analyze the data. In this context, I would like to mention that Government of India is to set up the National Research Foundation, NRF, which will initiate and expand research efforts in technology. The NRF will indeed play an important role in advancing core artificial intelligence research, developing and deploying application-based research, and advancing international research efforts to address global challenges. In recent years, as technology has developed and evolved, there have been disruptions everywhere. This will have even more far-reaching effects in the post-pandemic world. I am happy to note that with the support of the Department of Science and Technology, IIT Jodhpur has set up a technology innovation hub on computer vision, augmented reality, and virtual reality under the National Mission on Cyber Physical Systems. In the present context, the role of educational and research institutions is extremely critical. It is their work, their research, and innovations that will enable us to cope with the emerging challenges of the future. The COVID-19 crisis has resulted in a tectonic shift in our education system. Major universities and higher education institutions have partially and fully shifted to online mode of teaching and learning and are reporting considerable success in their endeavors. Further, availability of world-class technology platforms have enabled educational institutions to have a smooth transition to all online delivery mode. I am delighted to know, as it was shown in the presentation, that IIT Jodhpur also has taken up online activities in a very big way. Our understanding of COVID-19 situation continues to evolve. The need of social distancing will continue to affect traditional teachings and learning processes. A new normal in education might emerge, which will possibly have a lasting influence on pedagogy and assessment and evaluation modalities. While online education has many merits, it also has challenges. A few of that come to my mind, which I would like to list out. Conducting remotely proctored examinations is perhaps the most important challenge. It also requires pedagogical innovations by the faculty, change in evaluation modality, such as replacing examination by project or take-home challenges, can provide some viable and cost-effective alternatives. Another challenge is that of conducting laboratory classes and hands-on exercises for remote students. There may be a need to design and deploy a toolbox of online, virtual, and remote labs that can be used in different courses to bridge this gap. It can be an alternative to the bricks and mortar lab. Another limitation is lack or absence of human-to-human touch. Face-to-face interaction in education has a different value, which builds up the culture of an institute. Blended learning using a mix of online and on-campus resources could be an option. Further, in a multilingual country like ours, language barriers create complexity. Cutting-edge research in text translation and machine learning aims to create deep learning systems that can translate English lectures into a student's native language. Similar technologies in voice recognition and text summarization can transcribe an entire lecture and reduce paragraphs of text into relevant bullet points. And finally, teachers will require suitable training and development to be effective online educators. One cannot assume that a good teacher in a traditional classroom will automatically be a good teacher in an online classroom. Capacity building of teachers will be crucial to success of use of technology in education. So these are some of the challenges and issues which we must address. It is true that technology will create new opportunities and its adoption will be much faster. At the same time, technology that could have been subjected to greater regulatory security checks, such as use of artificial intelligence in healthcare, will likely to be fast-tracked and deployed. A possible risk is that some people can be permanently left behind as the process of digitalization is accelerated at a rapid pace. Inequalities could perhaps get aggravated and would need to be addressed. In other words, there are risks when we deploy technology very fast, the risk of security, the risk of privacy, and also maybe there could be more of inequity because of the digital divide. We are today at a time that was never imagined before, a unique time in our lives. For days, weeks, and months, people are within the confines of homes with their families and loved ones and living with a sense of uncertainty as to how the pandemic situation will develop. In an unprecedented way, the entire world is fighting an invisible enemy. It has posed a great challenge to science and technology. A quotation from Arthashastra highlighting the relevance of Wheel of Time is interesting. I would quote, Kalaha pachati bhutani, Kalaha sangrahate praja, Kalaha supteshu jagarti, Kalohi durati krama. Kalaha pachati bhutani, time ripens all beings. Kalaha sangrahate prajaha, time destroys all creatures. Maybe it will destroy the coronavirus. Kalaha supteshu jagarti, time is awake while all else sleeps. Kalohi durati krama, time is insurmountable. Maybe technology will change so fast that some people who are disadvantaged, for them it might be insurmountable. Time has thrown up several challenges for all of us. It is technology that can help us overcome the challenges. At the same time, new challenges arising by the use of technology are to be addressed by individuals and institutions through learning, teaching, and education. As I said earlier, a major challenge comes from the digital divide. As the National Education Policy also recognizes, the benefit of online and digital education cannot be leveraged unless digital divide is reduced or even eliminated through considerable efforts, such as initiatives like Digital India campaign and availability of affordable computer devices. It is important that the use of technology for online and digital education addresses concerns of equity. People who are disadvantaged should not become more deprived as time passes and education is much more digitalized. I recently read in one of the inside reports by the World Economic Forum that over a century ago, at the time of the Spanish flu, when people were isolating themselves, many people, of course mostly Americans, turned to telephone to get in touch with friends and family. At that time, it was a nascent technology. Services quickly broke down due to rapid use. As even today, mobile phone has problem during earthquake or some other disaster because a lot of people use it at the same time. But the Spanish flu underscored how essential the technology of telecom was to modern society. In subsequent years, in the 20th century, we all know how instrumental the telephone became in shaping the world as a global village. Possibly, we are at a similar reflection point in time today. Years later, historians would look back and assess how today's decision on digitalization or use of technology or digitalizing education would shape us as individuals, societies, and nations. Our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, has given us a clarion call for Atmanirbhar Bharat. It goes much beyond being a self-reliant nation. It envisages India's leading role in the global arena as a leader in technology and global supply chain of goods and services, including learning, education, and research. At the same time, it is also a social change paradigm where every individual is encouraged to strive for excellence in whatever she does. In this context, the role of education and higher educational institutions such as IIT Jodhpur is extremely important. They pave the way for achieving excellence and realizing national potential. In the end, I once again congratulate all of you as your esteemed institute embarks on a new phase of a long journey. Possibilities are immense. My best